Good morning, students. I am Dr. Tripti Gupta from Shivjyoti Education Group, Kota. So, students, today we are going to start with the revision session of a snapshot, chapter number 3, Ranga's Marriage. Now, this story is been written by Masthi Venkatesh Iyengar. Now, he is a Tamilian writer here, and he has. We will take up few of the points which are to be remembered here for this chapter. Let us start with the first few aspects of the chapter. Now, first of all, the author has given no fancy title of the story. Now, in the very first stanza, the author has justified that why he has given a very simple title, Ranga's Marriage, because he did not want to deviate or he did not want to have a very fancy kind of title here. He suggested few names which were probably maybe more catchy or may interest people more, but he found that probably Ranga's Marriage is a better title and which justifies the story properly. So, he had kept this to be a simple one as Ranga's Marriage. Now, the story starts with, as we can see here, the protagonist here is Ranga, a boy who has just returned back from Bangalore after completing his studies to his village Hosahalli. Now, let us see here, the village of Hosahalli is the next thing which has been described by the narrator here in this chapter, and he has given a very beautiful description that how his village is all about, how beautifully it has, the nature has blessed the village Hosahalli. It is in Madurai district in Karnataka. So, from there he moves to introduce about the various characters here, that is the lead character of this story is Ranga. Now, the next aspect we will deal here is Ranga's homecoming was a great event. So, the chapter starts with an event which was being experienced by the narrator here in his village, as Ranga has returned back from Bangalore after completing his studies. Now, what was different, why his homecoming became an event there, was because he was the only person who had gone for higher studies, and now he has studied in English medium. Now, people in the village, they were very curious about knowing that if a person goes and he studies English and he has been exposed to a different culture, the English culture or the English language. Now, how that has influenced the personality of Ranga, how he has changed, whether Ranga has forgotten all his traditions or culture, whether he has changed a lot because of the influence of English language. We understand this aspect here because in India, English language previously, now the scenario has quite changed, but previously people who used to study English or who used to know the language, English language, they used to be considered to be the elite class in the society, and this also has been described here by the narrator also, that everybody was very curious that how Ranga is now. When everybody was gathering around his house, and then Ranga came out, he greeted everybody, he bowed down, he touched the feet of elderly people. When narrator went to him, then also he greeted him in a very respectful manner, he touched his feet, and this is how he basically, narrator was very impressed finding Ranga, that he has retained all his cultural values and traditions, and he is basically the same boy who went to Bangalore for higher studies, there is hardly any influence of that language on the boy. Only thing is that he has studied it, nothing has been changed. And this is how this event was being concluded by the people of the village. Now, after that, narrator Shyama decides to get Ranga married. Now, his first, the narrator here, Shyama, is a neighbor to Ranga, and he, when he met Ranga, and that first interaction with Ranga made narrator to be very impressed of his personality, and he found that Ranga is a very nice boy. And during the conversation, he also got to know about Ranga's views on marriage, that how he is being more keen of marrying such a girl whom he knows before he marries the girl. One thing, another thing, he is not in the favor of marrying a very young girl with a lot of age difference. So he also was having a different set of idea regarding the marriage, which was quite different from the tradition which was being followed in their village. Now, though this was being a distressing aspect for Shyama, but then too Shyama was very impressed, and he was very determined that probably he will find a right match for Ranga. And that was with this particular determination and this idea, he finally went ahead, and the story moves ahead with this particular notion that Shyama is now, after this idea that he will make Ranga to get married to a nice girl whom he deserves. Okay, so now the next aspect which happened was the narrator found a suitable girl for Ranga. Very soon narrator was able to identify a sweet girl, Ratna. She is 11 years old at that time. Now she is the niece of a person in the villager resident in that village. He is Rama Rao, and her parents are no more at that time, and that is why she was being brought up in urban setup. She used to live in city, and because her parents passed away in an accident, she was being now living with Rama Rao, as they used to take care of her now. Now, Shyama found Ratna to be a very suitable girl for Ranga. This is how he identified that Ratna and Ranga both should get married. Now, from here, he starts finding out the ways or the solution how this match could actually be possible. So, after that, the story moves further. The narrator starts playing matchmaker. Now, from here, the role of narrator has just been transformed, and now he has started playing as a matchmaker. He made lots of arrangements that how to make a very perfect meeting, an interaction between Ranga and Ratna. So what he did, he asked Ratna to come to his house. He called her, and at that very same time he also made Ranga to come and visit his house. Meanwhile Ranga was been coming, he made Ratna to ask her to sing a song, and while she was been singing the song, Ranga came at that moment, and he was been mesmerized with the beautiful voice of Ratna, and he just kept standing outside the door and actually did not want to disturb the singer. But soon, just being curious that how this sound looks like. So he just peeped inside the window and his shadow made Ratna all of a sudden to be disturbed while she was singing, and she stopped singing at that very moment. And then Ranga went inside in a very shyful manner. Ratna went, she ran inside the house, and finally, and Ranga very curiously asked about who the girl is, and then Shyama made a mockery that, oh, probably this is a girl. Are you been interested in this girl? And he was been just mocking about Ratna too. And Ranga was being a bit embarrassed with this question, but then too he did not answer anything about that. But then too Shyama told about that this girl is being the niece of Rama. He introduced the different aspects, he details about Ratna, and then finally he told that probably this girl is being married a year before. So this made this information that Ratna is being a married girl made Ranga to be very disappointed at that moment, and that disappointment and that feeling of a depressed set of feeling was reflected on Ranga's face during that conversation. And this made Shyama, the narrator, to realize that probably he has made his point, and he has been he has clicked the right point where probably Ranga is being interested in Ratna. Now after that, the Ranga's disappointment, as I gave you the complete aspect that how Ranga was disappointed after knowing that Ratna is being married. Now his disappointment was being taken into account by the narrator Shyama, and the next day when he met Ranga, he was been talking about that why are you so distressed, and then he used to narrate about that in young time when I was searching for a girl, I used to go for finding right match, and at that time I also used to feel this kind of distress situation, and I used to get disappointed at times, and for that reason he suggested that Ranga should go and meet the astrologer. Now here, see here, the narrator's plan involving the astrologer Shastri. Now prior to this conversation, basically the narrator has made a plot in which he wanted the astrologer to be involved, and he wanted astrologer Shastri to influence Ranga by his calculations and by his suggestions that how actually what is making Ranga to be to feel that distressed situation, and this is all was been planned prior by Shyama. And after that, the next day Shyama took Ranga along with him to the astrologer as per the plan. The narrator's plan succeeds. Now as they both, the Ranga and the narrator Shyama, they both went to astrologer Shastri, and they were being Shastri made some display of calculating his horoscope, and then finally his out of that calculation he came out with the conclusion that probably your disappointment is because the reason behind is a girl, and that girl's name is related to something about ocean. And then he also suggesting few names, maybe the pearl, kamal, and then finally he came out with the name Ratna, and that made the here the narrator Shyama was quite, he expressed his amazement and surprise aspect at that moment when Shastri, he revealed about Ratna's name. Okay, then both of them, they went, and finally Ranga accepted and he agreed that probably he is being disappointed, feeling depressed, just because probably he Ratna is the girl. But at that moment Shyama, he was a bit surprised and saying that Ratna is a married girl, then how is this possible? But Shastri said that I do not know about all these facts, but this is what I have calculated and my Shastra, it conveys me this, and that's why I am telling you all about it. Now with this conversation, the both of them, they come out of their come out from the Shastri's place, and then they started moving back to their house. Now after that, finally the narrator, what he did during while they were coming back from the Shastri's house, he found Rama Rao's house in between, and he made Ranga to wait for some time outside, and he just went inside Rama Rao's house and he spent some time over there, maybe conversing with Rama Rao, and then he came out after spending some time, and then he, in a very surprising manner, he revealed Ranga that, see, I was been wrongly informed earlier, but probably somehow, I do not know from where that information came to me, but actually Ratna is not married and she is a nice girl. And with this information, Ranga got very happy about, and finally the narrator made him to agree that probably he wanted to marry Ratna, and that made Ranga and finally to agree to marry to Ratna. And Shyama was being able to perfectly the result of his plan succeeded finally, and Ratna and Ranga, they both agreed for this marriage. Now finally Ranga and Ratna get married. So their marriage was been properly arranged, and Ranga and Ratna, they got married. Now after 3 years of their marriage, they had a son, and there was a ceremony of their son's birthday ceremony. Shyama, the narrator, was very respectfully been invited by Ranga, because he was very like he found Shyama to be the reason, to be the person that he made Ratna to come in his life, and he is the responsible for his happy married life. And to pay to tribute and to give him respect, he named his son after Shyama's name, and he named his son Shyam in that ceremony. So in this manner, this story gets complete here. Now hopefully we have been able to complete and to take up all the key points of this story. Now let us discuss the NCERT questions and answers of this chapter. Okay students, let us now start with the questions and answers from NCERT. First question here is, comment on the influence of English, the language, and the way of life on Indian life as reflected in the story. What is the narrator's attitude to English? So this question basically relates to a thematic aspect of this chapter, that how English has made an influence on the Indian society. When English came to our land, they did not bring the industrialization alone. They carried with themselves their culture, their religion, their language to our home. The biggest of all influences was the language, English. Even after so many years of independence, we Indians are not able to pull ourselves out of this inferiority complex. They ruled our nations once, and now, even after so many years and decades, they rule our minds also. We consider those inferior who do not know English language. At times it happens. We have seen this happening in our day-to-day scenario. It is nothing but a language after all. We have probably been giving more importance to English as being required to any of the languages. It is as foreign language as any other foreign language, but too, we are being quite partial about English, that we can see here. We must treat a language as language and only, and not as a status symbol. What has been happening? This falsehood has been reflected very well in the story. The narrator Shyama showed how when Ranga returns from Bangalore after completing his studies, the way people anticipated his return and the excitement on knowing that Ranga now knew English, a priceless commodity they all wanted. They see here what happened when he returned from Bangalore. They all wanted to see if there has been any change in Ranga after studying English, and they were all being curious about that in Bangalore. However, there was no change or little in Ranga's personality. This has been described nicely by the narrator here. Now, another question here is about another thematic aspect which is being dealt here in the story, is about the marriage. Now, Indian society has moved a long way from the way the marriage is arranged in the story. Now, we have to discuss this aspect, that probably exactly it has happened. The story been describing quite old time when the way the marriages are being arranged in the story is been now. Probably we have moved far away from that period of time. It is true that the Indian society has evolved way beyond what has been portrayed in the story. The way Shyama arranged Ranga's marriage is not how it happens in the modern times now. Children today do not want to stay dependent on their parents or elders to choose their life partners. They now want to take control of their lives. They take a lead and decide themselves who they want to spend their lives with. The society has opened up to love marriages. However, it should be noted that love marriages are not modern. This culture has existed since ancient times in India. Many cases of love marriages can be traced back in the history, and we can find lots of instances. It is difficult to say whether arranged marriage is an old tradition or love marriage. So, we can be sure of at least one thing, that these are trends that come and go and people follow what is in being trend or fashion. So, this is how the things have been changed regarding with reference to the marriages in our culture. Okay, there is one more question here. What kind of person do you think the narrator is? Now, Shyama, a person who is too attached to his soil and his village, the narrator of the Ranga's marriage. When the story starts, the reader expects something about a marriage happening. However, the narrator takes the reader on a tour of his village Hosahalli, explaining the specialities about it. He does not believe in English culture. He was been a follower of our traditional Indian culture. Shyama is a person who respects a person who believes in his or her culture. For example, when Ranga, he paid homage to him, he bowed down, touched Shyama's feet as a namaskar. He was quite impressed because he was been truly following, his value systems were been intact. This made Shyama happy that even studying away from home, Ranga had not forgotten his values. Even though Ranga was an educated boy, was determined to get married to a girl who is mature enough. Shyama got him married to Ratna, who was much younger and not at all the kind of girl he would have married. This shows his belief in arranged marriage and also that he was a determined person who always got done what he had decided. He was a person who strongly believed in his traditions and culture. So probably now here we have taken up all the key points and the important aspects of this story being discussed here in our revision. Whatever doubt comes in your mind while going through the chapter, you can ask those doubts in the doubt session, students. So hopefully you have taken the chapter well in your account.